Can you all hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It is another great day in beautiful Bunnell, Florida. It's a great evening here. The weather is nice. And just wanted to start off with our first city manager podcast. First, we'd like to recognize our mayor, Catherine Robinson, our vice mayor, John Robin Rogers, Commissioner Bill Baxley, Commissioner Donnie Nobles, and our newest commissioner, Tanya Gordon. It's also, I want to recognize our team, our great team that we have here at the City of Bunnell, and in particular, our producer of tonight's show, our city clerk, Kristen Bates. The purpose of this monthly update from the city manager will be to inform our citizens, disseminate information, and to help share policy decisions that's made by our board. It's really to help our citizens better understand their local government. This is not intended to be a political platform, a complaining session, nor a debate. So we will have no sarcasm or insults. Simply, I want to convey information to help our citizens become more informed about its local government and the policies and actions that's taken by our city commissioners to benefit this community. Now, if you have any questions, comments, I'm asking that you wait until we get through our dissemination of information. My email address is ajackson@bunnellcity.us. Please, at any time, feel free to email questions, comments, suggestions. We will respond back to you, or either you can call me at any time of day. It's 386-986-6004. So the format of this session will be like fivefold. We want to do a did you know, sharing some historic nuggets, announcements, board actions from the last board meeting or the last two board meetings, our accomplishments, and always our challenges, because you as citizens have to work with us in overcoming our challenges to make Bunnell the best little city in the country. Tom DeWara of the University of Minnesota, the Humphrey Institute, said, clients are people who are dependent upon and controlled by their helpers and leaders. Clients are people who understand themselves in terms of their deficiencies, and people who wait for others to act on their behalf. Citizens, on the other hand, are people who understand their own problems in their own terms. Citizens perceive their relationship to one another, and they believe in their capacity to act. Good clients make bad citizens. Good citizens make strong communities. And we want to make Bunnell a strong community. So what we want to do is help our citizens be good citizens and well-informed. So let's start out with our nugget. Did you know that Watch Us Grow was the Bunnell motto in the early 1900s? Did you know in July of 1913, you could buy a 6-room cottage in Bunnell for $500? You only had to put 50 cents down and 50 cents a month until paid in full. Man, what a deal. Did you know that the original railroad track in Bunnell was laid in 1886 by businessman Utley J. White? It was sold to Henry Morris Flagler in 1889 adding to his Florida East Coast Railway. A second track was laid in 1913. And finally, Bunnell was named after Alva A. Bunnell, one of the first settlers in Bunnell. He built and owned numerous businesses in Bunnell before moving to Miami. So one of the things that I want to do is really just share information out of my city manager's monthly report. The April report publishes in May, which will be at our May 26th meeting. So the report that I'm going to share is our March 2020 update. Also, as a side note announcement, our state of the city, which is presented by our mayor, Catherine Robinson, the Honorable Catherine Robinson, will be June 22nd, 2020. Just want to share that the commission last year adopted a mission statement. And that mission statement is the City of Bunnell will provide its residents, businesses, visitors, partners, and staff with value-centric leadership to create a safe, sustainable, attractive, strong, and vibrant community while building on our rich heritage as the foundation to improve the city's economic future and to achieve the highest possible quality of life for the overall community through the exemplary services we provide. And so thus our vision is the City of Bunnell commits to building on its heritage. We have a rich heritage here that we're going to build on while enhancing a high quality of life for all its citizens. We pledge to work in collaboration with our residents and business community to foster pride in the city, develop a vibrant and diverse economy, and thoughtful plan for the future. And so that's our city mission and vision that we live by every day. It's driven by a strategic plan. We bring those actions to the commission for adoption. And in the next session, we will share our report card from our strategic plan at the six-month mark. You know, when we talk about local government, what we do here in the City of Bunnell, we have a lot of projects that are ongoing that you may not be aware of. Private sector projects, such as Grand Reserve, which is the next phase, will build about 117 new homes, which really adds to our tax base. We have an industrial park called Steel Rail. Basically, they are bringing in businesses into that industrial park. We recently was blessed by bringing in an international company that will manufacture herbal supplements. They just closed on that project last week, and that was about a $2.6 million deal. Once again, adding to our tax roll, and that project will create about 100 new jobs. Some of our public sector projects, we just completed what we would call phase one of the West Side Sewer and Drainage Rehabilitation. That is complete, and we have been blessed to receive another grant through St. John's Water Management District to start phase two of the West Side Sewer. And what we will be doing there is actually piping the drainage, stormwater drainage system there. Really getting rid of the ditches that are there and moving to a piping system. You may have seen some work that was taking place on 100, looked like they were laying pipes. They were. It's the what we call the State Road 100 reclaimed water line extensions. And once again, it's getting our reclaimed water out to areas such as Grand Reserve for their golf course and eventually other what we call public lands for watering. That project is completed. And so you see in areas where we're redoing sidewalks that were dug up and replanting grass. In the south side, over the last week, we had another grant from St. John's Water Management District, and that is actually what we call sewer slip lining. And that is where we are going into much older distribution pipes and slip lining them to reduce water intrusion or leakage, which is really improving our performance at our wastewater system. So those are some of the projects that are ongoing. Right now we have a total project expense about $202.2 million projects that's going on, and $2.1 million of those projects were grants. And so really hats off to our staff and to our commission as we attempt to really lessen the burden, the tax burden of our citizens by going after grants to help us on our projects. Let me just talk a little bit about solid waste, because a lot of times we don't have a real perspective of what we collect in our solid waste. And so for the month of March, our residential garbage, we collected about 128.87 tons. That's about 9.9 truckloads of residential garbage. Yard waste, 136 yards, that's about 6.8 truckloads. Commercial garbage, 147.86 tons, that's about 11.37 truckloads. Commercial cardboard, 21.63 tons, it's about 1.64 truckloads. And then construction and demolition and bulk debris, about 26.57 tons. That's about 7.59 truckloads. And so in that kind of gives you a perspective of what we are collecting in our solid waste. Always, everyone wants to know about the budget. How are we doing financially? Well, March was the 6th month of the fiscal year, 2019-2020. And which meant we were halfway through the year. The total budget, including amendments, was $10,458,241. And that includes anticipated revenues and expenditures of the city from October 1, 2019 to September 30th, 2020. The general fund, where most of those dollars come in from ad valorem taxes. The general fund has a total revenue of $2,377,677, while expenditures currently total $1.8 million. In our general debt service fund, which really paying back our municipal complex here, the monthly payments of that is about $5,600 each month for debt service. Our water sewer fund has a total revenue of $1.9 million. The expenditures total about $1.6 million. Our solid waste fund has revenues about $390,000 and expenditures about $339,000. $1,000. And so we're right on target as it relates to our expenditures. Just a few announcements. The city of Bunnell will be hosting what we call Artisans at the Crossroads, featuring the Florida Highwaymen. And we had to reschedule that to June 20th, 2020. It will be from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. At our historic Coquina City Hall in Lake Lucille. And that is, once again, Saturday, June 20th. Well, we have all been impacted by COVID-19. Our parks have been closed, City Hall has been closed. We've had to have modified staffing to keep our team safe. We have encouraged our staff to follow the CDC guidelines of wearing masks, social distancing. Well, we're in phase one of reopening. And on May 18th, which is today, we open EJ Park for exercise only. May 4th, we open up JB King and Carver Fields. Their times are from 10 a.m. until close, and that really gives us an opportunity to sanitize from the previous day's activities. Now, we are encouraging all residents and businesses, we're urging you to continue to follow Florida Department of Health and CDC guidelines, to include staying home except when engaged in essential services and activities, wearing cloth face coverings when out in public, practicing aggressive social distancing at all times. People should keep a minimum of 6 feet of space between one another and keep groups to less than 10, which includes while shopping and waiting in checkout lines. We encourage frequent washing of hands, at least 20 seconds, or use an alcohol base, at least 60% alcohol hand sanitizer. And so we like to just keep our community safe. We're trying to keep our team safe here. If you need to meet with someone, basically we can schedule a meeting, and our staff will be more than happy to meet with you. If you need to drop off permits, we have staff that can meet you at the front door. And we're encouraging individuals that need to pay their utility bills. We have a Dropbox. You can go online. You can pay using your debit card or your check. So we are trying to make accommodations even during this time of pandemic crisis. Want to just briefly give you an update on our city commission meetings. The agendas have been fairly short. The governor has allowed our commission to meet utilizing a digital format, which we call Zoom. And if you go to the City of Bunnell's website, you would be able to find those meeting times and our agendas. So in our April 27th meeting, there was an emergency resolution that postponed our state of the city, as I indicated earlier. Other than that, for that meeting, it was very short and non-eventful. Our May 11th meeting, we had a resolution that actually amended our 2019-2020 budget. You know, we are receiving dollars in as donations or sponsorships for our art show, so we had to amend the budget, as well as we had to amend the budget to receive our stormwater grant from St. John's Water Management District. So the way that works is that when we get a grant, we did not budget it for it. And so what we have to do is bring it back to the board, and the board has to budget that as a revenue, and then they have to budget the expenditure for that revenue. During that board meeting, we had to fill planning, zoning, plant PZA board. And basically there were actually five new board members appointed to the PZA. During that meeting, the board also approved a request for engineering services to engineer the West Side project for permitting, design, and construction. And that was approved by the board. And those were really the two actions that occurred in that meeting. One of the things that I want to mention that the board adopted a master utility plan on March 9th. And in that plan, it was a total of 10-year capital expenditure of about $47 million. And basically that plan said that these are the projects that we need to undertake over the next 10 years to expand and improve our water and our wastewater system. You know, we talk about economic growth, we talk about economic development, we talk about housing development. Well, we have to have the infrastructure, we have to have the sewer system capacity to accommodate that growth. And at this point in time, we have a crumbling sewer system that's undersized that we really need to work on expanding and modernizing so that we can position ourselves to receive this economic development as well as residential growth. And I want to share this with you because the total cost, $47.4 million. The treatment center system is going to be about $19.7 million. The collection improvements, about $10.4 million. Reclaimed water, about $6.3 million. Pipe upsizing, $1.2. We mentioned that we have undersized and inferior piping, other costs, wells, some of the work that needs to be done on wells and other capital, that all comes out to about $47.4 million. And so we have a system here that's over 100 years old, and it is long due to be upgraded. And so one of the things that we will be bringing back to the commission in two meetings is to start looking at our rates and opportunities to go after USDA loans to start this project. And as I indicated, it's a 10-year project, but the wastewater plant expansion is imperative. If we don't expand our wastewater system, we are very close to capacity, then the Department of Environmental Protection will actually stop us from issuing building permits. And so this is a priority project for the city of Bunnell and its commission. And so we just wanted you to understand what that cost and what the nature of those projects are. And if you have any additional questions, please don't hesitate to give me a call. And that's my city manager's update for this first session. We have, I believe, about 2 minutes. Any questions?
Mr. Jackson?
Yes, Mayor Robinson.
Yes, I just want to congratulate you on your first public event here to the citizens of Bunnell, and I look forward to the updates as they come forward on a monthly basis. So thank you for doing this.
Thank you, Mayor. Any other questions or comments? If not, we will see you in June, the third week in June at 6 p.m. Once again, it is another great day in beautiful Bunnell, Florida, the best city in the country. Thank you.